We are going to continue with our series of teachings.
Sizoqhubeka nesifundiso sethu.
Standing before you is Zulindo Kuhle Dlamini.
Omngaphambili umfundisi uDlamini.
I'm a child of God.
Ngumntwana kaNkuluNkulu.
Amen.
Amen.
We are going to continue with our series of teachings.
Sizoqhubeka nesifundiso sethu.
A true disciple of Christ.
Umfundi weqiniso kaKristu.
Following in his footsteps.
Silandela ezinyathelweni zakhe.
Keeping his pace.
Sigcina isivinini sakhe.
Amen.
Amen.
We are not going to go back.
Ngeke saphindele emuva.
To that which you have already covered.
Kulokho esesikubhekile.
But I would like us to go straight to slide number 15.
Sizobheka uslide 15.
Serving in humility. And so, when he had washed their feet and taken his garments and reclined at the table again, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for so I am. If I then, the Lord and the teacher, washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I gave you an example that you should do as I did to you. Truly, truly, I say to you, a slave is not greater than his master, neither is one who is sent greater than the one who sent him." There was John chapter 13 from verse 12 to verse 16.
From this slide, we do see that we are speaking about serving in humility. When we're speaking about humility, we're speaking about freedom from pride or arrogance. Humility is a state of being humble. So if you take a look at this verse, you do see that it is actually speaking about the position that the Lord did bow to wash the disciples'
feet,
which actually speaks of stooping low, which actually speaks also of, which speaks more about posture. As you serve. If I may have two people so that we can do the illustration. Picture this with me. Let us say this was the disciple of the Lord. And this is the Lord Jesus Christ. So let us presume the disciple will be seated. So let us get our disciple to sit. And then the Lord to approach the feet. So you do see here that when we're speaking about the feet, we're speaking about the part of the body that is low. So when the Lord had now to wash the feet of the disciple, the word of God is not clear, but I presume he had to fall or he had to go to the level of the foot. I'm not too sure if we do realize that this actually speaks about posture, which speaks about humility. But as you serve, I'm not too sure if we're following. Amen. So when we serve in humility, we do not serve only those who seem to be worthy. Or those who qualify to be saved, but we serve everyone. In the beginning of this chapter, the book of John, chapters number
13,
John reminds us that the devil had already seized the Judas's heart to betray the Lord Jesus Christ. Then the Lord, when he knelt before Judas, as we have seen when we made the when we demonstrated in front, he rendered a service to Judas as a slave. The Lord served as a slave. Because you'll actually see ukuthi izinyawo zasikade zigezwa because of indlela, the nature of the shoes that were worn at that time.
Where the washing of the feet spoke of the path or the journey walked.
So okushukuthi izinyawo probably zazinalo uthuli.
That means that the feet were filled with dust.
Now we see the Lord kneeling down and washing those feet.
Sayibona inkosi ikhothama igeza zona lezo nyawo.
Which then tells us that the Lord, as he served, he set a pace when it comes to humility. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord says, you are all clean, when he's speaking to his disciples. But not every one of you. All that Judas could have been thinking was that he knows that I've made an agreement to sell him. Because beginning of this chapter, maybe can you give us the book of John, chapters number 13, verse 1.
Sorry. John 13, verse 1. Now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come, that he should depart from this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And supper being ended, the devil having already put it into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him. Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God.
Now, we do see that here Judas' heart has been seized already. Judas's heart has been captured. But when the Lord is washing the feet of his disciples, he washed the feet of Judas Iscariot too. So probably in Judas's mind, he was thinking, oh my God, he knows. As he speaks these words, as he says to his disciples that you are all clean, but not every one of you. So based on what Judas had already conceived in his heart, he probably knew that when the Lord spoke these words, he was speaking to him. Now, we do see a picture here. The disciples seated, which is Judas Iscariot. And the Lord Jesus who's washing the feet. Which then tells us that we do not serve only those who are good to us when we serve in humility. Because on the other hand, Jesus, as he bent over to dirty feet of Judas, and washed them with water and then wipes them, he was not only washing the feet of a man with an evil heart, but he was washing the feet of one of his disciples, whom he had chosen to partake in his ministry. So we see, Bazalwane, Judas, on the other hand, he's saying, oh, the Lord knows that I'm going to sell him. But on the other side, the Lord Jesus Christ is saying, inasmuch as I know, But I'm looking at the future. As I serve him. Because probably he may change. Probably he may repent. Letting me wash his feet. So the Lord Jesus never treated Judas differently than all his disciples. Even though he knew everything because he was God. So he pointed.
The point we're driving to here
is that when we serve in humility,
we do not only serve those who do good to us, but we serve everyone.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's continue with our presentation. So we have already spoken about this point, that foot washing was done because of the type of shoes worn. That the mode of travel and the nature of climate, a master did not wash the 7 feet. We did speak about this point that the Lord, when he served as a slave. Because no master can wash the seven, can wash the feet. So we do get here that in the house of the Lord, we do not employ the strategies of the world. Because in the world, the one who is the least,
it is said, lo omncinane,
uyena okufanele enze umsebenzi odelelekile,
is the one that should do the least amount of work.
But in the house of the Lord,
kodwa endlini kaNkulunkulu,
sithola uJesu himself,
we find the Lord uQobo,
Jesus himself,
uJesu Qobo,
doing umsebenzi obukeka sengazathi udelelekile,
enza the work that looks small or is despised,
umuntu ongafanelekile,
to someone who is not worthy,
ngokwe condition yenhliziyo yakhe,
according to the condition of his heart.
Amen. After Jesus washed the disciples' feet, he taught them the meaning of what he had done. Next slide. Jesus was able to provide this example of humility because he had secure in his relationship with his father. He was not going to be able to wash his disciples if enhlizweni yakhe umsebenzi wawungenzekanga.
He was to wash his disciples' feet if the work in his heart was not yet complete.
Because remember that Jesus, when he came to the world, he was 100% man and he was 100% God. Because the word of God tells us that we do not have a high priest who does not sympathize with our weaknesses. For in every area he was tested. So we do see here that when the Lord serves, because God was not washing the disciples, but he was using his own body, his own earthly hands, Zazu washer the feet of the disciples.
They were the ones that were washing the inyawza bafundi.
So when we are asked, therefore, to serve in humility, the Lord is not asking for something that is out of the ordinary. But he is asking something that anyone can be able to do. Because he has capacitated us. Through the examples that he set before us. Amen.
Amen.
The modern disciple will never meet the pace-setting actions of Jesus until he too can feel secure in his relationship with the Heavenly Father. You remember when we were speaking about pace? When we were defining pace, we had two parts. We made an example of pavilion and the Portuguese hall. And we said pace is actually speaking about the distance covered over time. So it means we have to cover a certain distance, but over a particular time. That is pace. So as we are speaking about this, we are now speaking about it to say, you cannot serve in humility unless you are found in the Lord himself. Because remember that we spoke about it, we said, following the footsteps of the Lord and keeping his pace are two different things. You can follow his steps without keeping his pace. Are we still following,
Bazalwane?
Amen. Let's go back. Foot washing threatens one insecurities. This event in the life of disciples would never be forgotten. Surely Peter would never forget what Jesus did and his response. So we do see that here, and also, so he came to Simon Peter. He said to him, Lord, do you wash my feet? So this is after Peter saw that the Lord Jesus Christ was washing the feet of his disciples. Now Peter is asking this question. So this question is on the basis of what Peter knew, what he associated washing of the feet with. Peter knew that the washing of the feet has nothing to do with the Lordship. That is why when he speaks, he said, he starts by saying, Lord, do you wash my feet? Jesus answered and said to him, what I do you do not realize
now,
but you shall understand thereafter. Then Peter said to him, never shall you wash my feet. Jesus answered him, if I do not wash you, you will have no part with me. Then Peter now changes. He's now saying, Simon Peter said to him, Lord, not my foot only, but also my hands and my head. So
you can see now.
He's now changing.
We are shinja man.
Because he heard what the Lord said.
Ngoba ezwe lokho okushiwe
inkosi. When the Lord said he will not have part in his kingdom,
ngathi ethi ngeke azabe nasabele embusweni wakhe,
if he is not allowing him to wash his feet.
Ume ngamvumela ukuthi amgeze izinyawo.
Amen.
Amen.
Next slide. So here we do see, it is interesting to see how Peter discussed humility in his writings. So we do see here that it was demonstrated to Peter how to serve in humility. And this, what he saw the Lord doing, he is now speaking about it. Amen. So this now goes to show, Uguti, when we are speaking about the pace of the Lord, it is not only what the Lord is teaching, but it is also what the Lord does. So Ogushu Gutige, when we serve in the house of the Lord, or when we live the life of salvation, it is not only about what we profess, but it is also about what what we do.
Because
the Lord is also interested in your works. Remember that the heart, everything that lands to your heart is either going to come out of your mouth, one, or through your actions. Amen.
Amen.
Remember last week we spoke about saying, Uguti, when we're speaking about someone believing in the Lord or coming to Christ, they profess with their mouths and believe in their hearts. But we did mention that it is possible to profess with your mouth but deny through your actions. What you speak with your mouth,
which means that
needs to go hand in hand with what you do. Amen.
Amen.
Next slide. I hope we still understanding, Bazalwane Uguti, we are speaking about the pace of Christ in all under these subheadings. So we are speaking about the pace of Christ when he serves in humility. We
are
speaking about the pace of Christ when it comes to prayer, to his life of prayer. Amen. Can I have two people again? Can I have an extra person? This is point A. This is point B. This is where she is. You may be excusing, Pastor. This is where she is. This is her destiny. So when we're speaking about prayer, we are speaking about the foundation to everything that pertains to impilo
yomzalwane. With the life of a believer.
So when we're speaking about this point A and point B, and this individual, this is her destiny. But what links her and the destiny is prayer. Walk that. You can stop. Come. You can stop there. Siyabonga. So, what you've seen or what you have witnessed, she was walking this direction. But her destiny is that way. So it is possible to live a life that is facing on the opposite side of your direct of your destiny. If you do not pray. There are people according to God's calendar or according to God's divine diary
who have not yet started living
because abakaqali to walk towards the direction that has been set for them.
Because abakahambi ngendlela ebakhombela esiphethweni sabo.
But the problem is that they cannot find it because they are not doing it due diligence when it comes to prayer.
Inkinga ukuthi abakwazi ukuyithola ngoba bengakhuleki ngokwanele.
Remember what we said. We said prayer links you with your destiny.
Sithe umkhuleko onoxhumanisa nesiphetho sakho.
We do see this when the Lord is praying in the Garden of Gethsemane.
Siyabona la inkosi khuleka eGethsemane.
The word of God tells us that he sweat.
Sweats of blood.
But he was praying. He was saying, Father, let this cup pass, but not my will. So you do see what prayer does. Prayer assist you to come to the point of realizing your destiny. Amen.
A life of a prayer, reading from Mark chapter 1, verse 35. And in the early morning, while it was still dark, He arose and went out and departed to a lonely place and was praying there.
Look. Amen. So we do see here that the Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God says, in the early morning, while it was still dark, he arose and went out and departed to a lonely place and was praying there. So we are bona ukuthi prayer aina so is cut.
You can see that umkhuleko does not have time.
Prayer, you do not find time to pray, but you make time to pray. Awukhuleke just because kwenzekile waqwasha ebusuku wangalala.
You do not pray because maybe you had insomnia and could not sleep at night.
But you wake up to pray.
God, we are vuka ukhuleke.
Amen. Ngiyacela sibuke the book of Daniel chapters number 10 verse 12 to 14.
The book of Daniel, chapter 10, from verse
this
12.
This is like our theme verse.
Amen.
Daniel, chapter 10, verse 12, reading from the New King James Version. Then he said to me, "Do not fear, Daniel, for from the first day that you set your heart to understand and to humble yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I have come because of your words. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 21 days, and behold, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, for I had been left alone there with the kings of Persia. Now I have come to make you understand what will happen to your people in the latter days, for the vision refers to many days yet to come."
So we do see here, Bazalwane,
siyabona la,
that we need to persist. You do not need to pray once and then besuyama, and then you say, "I know, Kshuti, this was not the Lord's will."
And then you stop saying,
because what we're learning here is that we do have an adversary whose mandate and job is to resist anything that pertains to us
that comes from God.
Can you imagine if Daniel stopped in day
11
and said, "I know, time out. The Lord has not heard my prayer.
No,
the Lord has heard my prayer. But I'm praying amiss.
Which means,
so let me just keep quiet and not pray." Can you imagine that? And ask yourself if the understanding that we get from what the Lord came with. Were we going to glean from what Daniel got? We wouldn't have understanding of the end times. We wouldn't have understanding of ukuthi kuzokwenzakalani ngesikhathi esikuzona namhlanje.
We would not besingesikwazi ukuqonda about the things that will be happening in these times that we are living
Daniel
in.
If Daniel did not persist.
Uma ukuthi uDaniel akaphokophelanga.
If Daniel did not take a daily dose of prayer.
Uma ukuthi uDaniel wayengakhuleki usuku nosuku.
Amen. Let us say someone is sick. Maybe you've got an abscess. Unetumba. You've got an abscess.
Unetumba.
And then you go to your doctor.
Uhambe kudokotela.
And then he gives you antibiotics.
Abese ekunikeza ama antibiotics.
And then he tells you, the doctor tells you, "No, you need to take these antibiotics for 7 days.
Abese ethi kumele uyiphuze le mshenguze insuku eziyisikhombisa.
And then you decide.
Ebese uyanquma.
Ukuthi, "No, I'm going to take for 3 days.
Uthi cha, mina ngizophuza insuku ezintathu.
Because the doctor is telling me something else.
Ngoba udokotela ungitshele enye into.
Mina ngiyazi ukuthi these antibiotics would have kicked in my system and they will work 3 days.
I know my body and zizokwazi ukusebenza emva kwentsuku ezintathu."
Guess what you would have done?
Awucabangi into ozoyenza ke?
The antibiotics will not work. But after them not working, you will develop resistance. You would not, even if that bacteria was sensitive to the antibiotics you were given by the doctor. When it happens next time that you suffer from the same bacteria, it is not going to, even if you are given those antibiotics, they are not going to work. So if we drop the ball in prayer, if we drop the ball and not persist in prayer, what we are doing, we are giving the devil the time to form more resistance. Because he would know what were the contents of our prayer and what sort of resistance he needs to put in place so that we do not pray. That is why sometimes when it is your time of prayer,
you find that a call will come in.
During your time of prayer, there's something you find yourself just occupied. It is because the devil is trying to deter you from that which you are praying about. So here we're learning a principle. We persist up until we see the results. Because we may find that the answer was released in heaven on day one, just like it happened to Daniel, but only to find there is some prince of Persia somewhere who is withholding. Do we understand? Amen. Let us read Genesis chapters 18, verse 26 to 29.
Genesis chapter 18 from verse 26 to verse 29. Amen. So the Lord said, if I find in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for their sakes. Then Abraham answered and said, indeed now, I who am but dust and ashes have taken it upon myself to speak to the Lord. Suppose there were 5 less than the 50 righteous. Would you destroy all of the city for the lack of 5? So he said, if I find there 45, I will not destroy it. And he spoke to him yet again and said, suppose there should be 40 found there. So he said, I will not do it for the sake of 40.
This is the pattern.
Nali pattern.
Of how you ought to pray. You must persuade God to such an extent that he lowers the level towards certain individuals or certain people or certain nations.
We see his level of wrath. We do see here that
when Abraham prayed, when he spoke to him, it was about the destruction of Sodom.
What
if there are 50?
If we find 50 people,
no, I wouldn't destroy it.
The Lord says,
and then it goes down in number. If there are
40,
then the Lord said, no, I wouldn't. Then the number keeps going. Keeps going. So what we're finding here, we're finding a pattern of intercession. Amen. We do not find a pattern that says, therefore, babulani.
As it told it, no, they have seen Lord kill them all.
Because that is not intercession.
Ngoba khona unxusa lokho.
Amen. Intercession speaks of us persuading uNkulunkulu.
Ukunxusa kukhuluma ngathi simcenga uNkulunkulu.
To come to a level
ukuthi afinyelele endaweni
of accepting and changing people.
Ukuthi amkele aguqule abantu.
So siyabona bazalwana ngithi.
We can see here.
We are speaking about prayer.
Sikhuluma ngomkhuleko.
So number one, we spoke about
okokuqala sithe
ukuthi when it comes to prayer, we must persist.
Ukuthi uma sikhuluma ngomkhuleko kumele siphikelele.
Number two, we are finding
okwesibili siyathola
the pattern in which we need to employ when we interceding.
Ipattern ekumele sisebenzise uma sinxusa.
Amen. Can we go to the presentation?
Luke chapter 6, verse 12. And it was at this time that he went off to the mountain to pray, and he spent the whole night in prayer to God.
Yeah, so and it was at this time that he went off to the mountain to pray.
We
the pattern that we find here is that Inkosi yayibashiya.
Siyathola ipattern that the Lord would leave
He would leave his disciples.
Abashiya abafundi
bakhe. He would leave the crowd.
Ashiye isixuku.
And go and pray.
Ahambe eyokhuleka.
Siyabona bazalwa?
We can see.
So we find here that we must have our times of prayer.
Siyathola la ukuthi kumele sibe nezikhathi zethu
zokukhuleka. We must have our times of ukunyomuka from the izixuku.
Kumele sibe nezikhathi zethu where we separate ourselves from the crowds.
Amen. Luke chapters number 9 verses 18.
And it came about that while he was praying alone, the disciples were with him, and he questioned them saying, "Who do the multitude say that I am?"
We are born at this question that the Lord asked His disciples.
Lombuzo inkosi yabuza abafundi bayo.
It was very difficult to answer this question.
Kwakunzima kakhulu ukuphendula lombuzo.
If you were walking according to the flesh.
Uma ukuthi wawahamba ngenyama.
Because when you walk according to the flesh, you are placing yourself in a position of not being able to receive
uzibeka endaweni la ungekwazi khona ukamkela
anything that proceeds from God.
Yonke into evela kuNkulunkulu.
But when you walk in the spirit,
kodwa uma uhamba uholwa umoya,
you are placing yourself in a position of being able to hear
uzibeka endaweni la uzokwazi khona ukuzwa
clearly the voice of God.
Ngokucacile iphimbo likaNkulunkulu.
Then when you read the response,
uma ufunda impendulo,
the Lord is asking his disciples. This was after 2 years.
Inkosi buza abafundi bakhe emva kweminyaka emibili.
Ehambe nabo.
Then he was with them.
They have seen the miracles, they've seen everything eyayenzeka.
Sebeyibonile imangaliso and everything else that was happening.
They saw, they witnessed the Holy Spirit coming in a form of a dove.
Umoya ngcwele ehla njengesimo sejuba.
They were there when the Lord spoke to the Lord Jesus and said, "This is my son."
Bekhona bezu uNkulunkulu osezulwini ekhuluma ngoJesu ethi le indodana yami.
But when the Lord was asking them this question, they were not in a position of answering him.
Kodwa inkathi inkosi babuza lo mbuzo, babengekho endaweni la babengamphendula khona.
But we do see that Peter now stands and he responds to the question.
Siyabona ke uPetro esukuma ephendula umbuzo.
And when the Lord is speaking to him, he says,
Uma inkosi ikhuluma naye uthi,
uthi lokho okukhulumayo you do not flesh and blood did not reveal it to you.
He says what you have spoken akusi inyama negazi eyambulele
kuwe. But it has been revealed by my Father in heaven.
Kodwa wabulelwe ubaba osezulwini.
And then the Lord said to him,
Inkosi yathi kuye,
from now on
kusukela manje
igama lakho seliyashintsha.
I will change your name.
So we are born now ukuthi he is receiving a revelation of who God is,
we can
of who
see
Christ
him
is.
Receiving isambulo ukuthi ungubani uKristu.
And his name changes.
Ebese kuguquka kushintsha igama lakhe.
So this is speaking about us living the life.
Lokhu kukhuluma ngathi siphila impilo.
That is a full of the Spirit of God.
Le egcwele umoya kaNkulunkulu.
That then assist us to come to the point.
Osisizayo ukuthi sikwazi ukufinyelela endaweni.
Of knowing who God is.
Ukuthi sazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu ungubani.
At a personal level.
Simazela thina.
Amen. kungokunye ukwazi uNkulunkulu ekukhulunywa ngaye.
It is another thing knowing about the God that is being spoken of by other people.
Then ukwazi uNkulunkulu okhuluma ngaye ngobumazi at a personal level.
But knowing God for yourself, uzazela wena.
Amen. Now, awukwazi ukukhuluma ngoNkulunkulu.
You cannot speak of God.
If you did not start in prayer.
Uma ukuthi awuqali emkhulekweni.
Because we said prayer sets the baseline.
Ngoba ke sithe umkhuleko uyona sekelo.
When it comes to our destiny.
Uma ke sikhuluma ngesiphetho sethu.
There is nothing that kicks off without prayer.
Ayikho into eqalayo noma esukayo ngaphandle komkhuleko.
The Lord Jesus knew that he was not going to be able to gain power.
Inkosi uJesu wayazi ukuthi ngeke akwazi ukuthola amandla.
Even to stand the cross.
Nokuthi akwazi ukuya esiphambanweni.
If he did not start off by praying.
Uma ukuthi akaqalanga emkhulekweni.
Amen. So prayer gives momentum.
Ngakho ke umkhuleko upha amandla.
Of everything that we do.
Amandla kawo konke sikudinga ukwazi ukwenza yonke into.
Amen. So if you are a child of God, you must do yourself favor.
Uma ukuthi umntwana kaNkulunkulu kumele uzenzele lo musa nalo ufefe.
Do not neglect these two things.
Ungayishayi indiba lezinto zombili.
Prayer and the word.
Umkhuleko nezwi.
And the devil will do everything in his power.
USathane uzokwenza konke okusemandleni akhe.
Just to make sure that you do not pray.
Uqinisekise ukuthi awukhuleki.
That he makes sure that you do not read the word.
Aqinisekise ukuthi awulifundizwe.
Because he knows ukuthi uzosala.
You'll be left behind.
Because inkosi izothi lapha ya.
Because as the Lord will be there lapha ngasemnyango.
Wena uzobusatabalasa la.
You'll still be staggering here.
Because you do not pray.
Ngoba ukhuleki.
Remember what we're saying? We're saying prayer gives momentum.
Umkhuleko sipha amandla.
To everything that we do.
Kuyo yonke into esiyenzayo.
So everything esiyenzayo, we must do it prayerfully.
Everything that we do, kumele siyenze ngomkhuleko.
And asimi ukukhuleka just because asiwabonanga ama results that we desire.
Stop praying because asibona imphumela lethi nesifisayo.
But we persist in prayer.
Kodwa siyaphikelela emkhulekweni.
Up until we see the hand of the Lord.
Uze kube siyasibona isandla senkosi.
In every matter.
Kuyo yonke into.
Amen.
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 Can we continue?
Jesus did not rely on his own power to accomplish his mission, but knew that constant communication with the Father was of utmost importance.
You can't serve in the house of God.
Awukwazi ukukhonza endlini kaNkulunkulu.
Ngendlela that the Lord desires.
In the way in which the Lord efisa ngayo.
You cannot serve in his house.
Awukwazi ukukhonza endlini yakhe.
Ngendlela that brings glory to the Lord.
In the manner in which kuletha inkazimulo enkosini.
If you do not communicate with him constantly.
Uma ukuthi awuxhumani nayo njalo njalo.
Because you communicating with him constantly.
Ngoba njengalokhu lodwa uxhumana naye njalo njalo.
It gives you an opportunity to open up to him.
Ukunikeza ithuba lokuthi uzivulele kuye.
And hear him.
Ukwazi ukumuzwa.
So that he may order your steps.
Ukuze kube uyena ohambisa izinyathelo zakho.
So that when it is time for you to take a turn.
Ukuze uma sekumele ujike.
You do not miss a turn.
Awuphuthi la kumele ujike khona.
Remember that prayer is communication.
Ukuthi ke umkhuleko kuxhumana.
You communicate with God.
Umana noNkulunkulu.
And God communicates with you.
NoNkulunkulu axhumane nawe.
So there is your part.
Khona ingcenye yakho.
And there is a part from
nengcenye kaNkulunkulu.
The Lord. So siyabona ama examples angithi bazalwane.
We can see the examples.
We do see the Lord going into prayer.
Siyabona inkosi
yemkhulekweni. Siyabona nokuthi uyakhuleka nasebusuku.
We can see him also praying during the night.
Siyabona futhi ukuthi uyaphuma nasezinqukwini ahamba ukukhuleka.
And also coming out of the crowds and going to pray.
Okusho ukuthi prayer is not something that we do corporately.
Okusho ukuthi umkhuleko asikhuleki kuphela sihlangene sibaningi.
But it is something we do individually.
Kodwa yinto esiyenza singamunye ngamunye.
Amen.
Jesus did not use his power to bless his disciples, but to bless them. Jesus was a pace setter in showing the disciples to always depend upon their Father for the power and strength to succeed in their mission. Amid the busy pressure of the ministry, the disciples often found Jesus in prayer.
We do see, Bazalwane.
Can we understand?
Some do not allow the work of the Lord to get it between you and the Lord himself. In fact, do not allow anything that is going to get between you and the Lord. So, we need to make sure that we keep our times of prayer. You will see some other time, maybe when the Lord allows, we will speak about watchers. What does it mean to be a watchman? You set a pattern. When it comes to prayer. Because you understand when you are not in your post, anything can happen to the city. The enemy can come and break the wall and gain access anytime. If you are not in your post. Leli gama elithi watchman, it's speaking about ukuqapha.
This it's speaking of being a watchman,
which is directly linked when you look at it closely,
or a watcher uma ke sibheka sisa kahle,
with prayer.
Lixhumene kakhulu nomkhuleko.
Do we have watchmen in the house?
Bakhona yena baqaphi?
Fanele singaba ama watchmen ngegama kodwa.
We should not only be a watchman by name,
the prayer closet yethu.
God also in our prayer closet.
Isifakazele.
Must also testify.
Next slide.
Jesus knew that his example of prayer to the Father would sustain disciples when the journey was tough. A prayerless disciple would be a powerless disciple. Jesus knew his example of prayer to the Father will sustain the disciples when the journey was tough. A prayerless disciple will be a powerless disciple.
Amen. It sounds right now. Yeah. Amen. So we do see here, ukuthi bazalwane, when we do not pray,
uma singakhuleki,
it becomes very difficult even for you to be able to perceive and to incline yourself even to the promptings of the Spirit. We made an example of Gethsemane. You know, when it was
that he produced sweats of blood.
The scientific term for that is hematidrosis. Which speaks about stress and anguish that one experienced to such an extent that the sweat glands, the blood vessels that are around the sweat glands. They begin to rupture and pour blood inside the sweat glands. So that when you see someone sweating blood, so that gives us an idea that when the Lord Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane, it was very difficult. It was not easy. But the decision he took was that he was going to incline his ear to the voice of the Father. Now I'm sure many of us were going to say, "Ay, Nkosi,
ay." Lord,
thank you. No, akumele ngiyekufeni ngoba vele mina. The Lord said, "I died for me. Akumele ngiexperience izinto ezimbi.
I'm not supposed to experience bad things.
Izinto ezinhle kuphela.
God only wants to do good things to us."
But we are born la ukuthi the Lord had to endure. And he had to ask his will
afune intando
yakhe. He had to ask God to assist him for sake.
Acele ukuthi inkosi imsize alasha indiva.
What he wanted to do.
Alahle lokhu yena
ayefuna ukwenza. Because the truth of the matter is that the Lord Jesus wayethi basically that prayer he was just saying.
Ngoba ngeqiniso ukuthi uJesu wayethi
Nkosi uma ngabe ikhona indlela esingenza ngayo ukuze sifela ukuze sisize abantu ukuthi bazane nawe.
If there is any other way for us to help these people to be reconciled with you.
Ngicela senze yona.
Let us take that way.
But uNkulunkulu wathi no.
But God said cha.
I'm a God of justice.
NgiuNkulunkulu wokulunga.
I'm a God of righteousness.
NgiuNkulunkulu wokulunga nokulungisa.
What I have said in my word through my holy prophets.
Ezwini lami ngabaprofeti bami.
It needs to be accomplished.
Kumele kufezeke.
Then Jesus, we see him
siyambona uJesu
submitting to the will of the Father.
Ezithoba entandweni kaBaba.
Amen.
Amen.
So it is only in prayer
kusemkhulekweni kuphela
that we learn to submit our wills to the will of the Father.
La esifunda khona ukuthobisa intando yethu ngaphansi kwentando kaBaba.
Because prayer tames even our flesh.
Umkhuleko ubamba utuba inyama yethu.
Because prayer
ngoba umkhuleko
tames
uyayibamba uyayithuba
what our flesh desires.
Lokhu okufunwa inyama yethu.
Prayer is able to put
umkhuleko uyakwazi ukubeka
ama breaks to your own flesh
enyameni yakho.
Manje ke uma if you do not pray
uma ungakhuleki
uzobona isono sizokuvama impela.
You will see that sin will abound in your
and
life
and the fruits of sin are going to be very prevalent in your life.
Isithelo sesono sizovela kakhulu empilweni yakho.
Amen. It is not enough
akwanele
that we come to church.
Ukuthi size enkonzweni.
It is not enough
akwanele
that we do come to church every Sunday.
Ukuthi siyeza njalo ngesonto enkonzweni.
But we need to be converted.
Kodwa kumele siguqulwe.
Insindiso eyabaguquliwe.
Salvation is for those who have been converted.
Insindiso yilabo eyalabo abafanisiwe noKristu.
Salvation is for those who have been likened unto Christ.
Now baningi abantu abeza enkonzweni kodwa abayinkuni zasehogweni.
There are many people who come to church but they are logs for hell.
Kunqabeke lokho.
Do refuse to be like that.
You must refuse.
Kumele unqabe.
Ukuthi uyesihogweni.
For you to go to hell.
Qaba ngomzimba wakho.
Refuse with your body.
Qaba with your soul.
Refuse nangomphefumulo wakho.
Do not allow your flesh to be an instrument.
Ungavumeli inyama yakho ibe ithuluzi.
Of sin.
Lesono.
But let your flesh be an instrument.
Kodwa umzimba wakho kumele ube ithuluzi.
Of righteousness.
Lokulunga.
Cela siqhubeke.
Jesus was a pace setter in the area of courage. He showed courage in the face of frightening situations. One of those situations is recorded in Mark 5, when Jesus' boat landed in the country of Gerasenes with his disciples. They were met by a wild man. Mark gave us a vivid description of him.
Next slide.
Mark chapter 5, verse 3 to verse 6. And he had his dwelling among the tombs, and no one was able to bind him anymore, even with a chain, because he had often been found with shackles and chains, and the chains had been torn apart by him, and the shackles broken in pieces, and no one was strong enough to subdue him. And constantly, night and day, among the tombs and in the mountains, he was crying out and gashing himself with stones. And seeing Jesus from a distance, he ran up and bowed down before him.
Amen. So what we're learning from this passage of scripture
is that
we do not allow distractions to come before us and serving the Lord courageously.
Another would have said, no one can tame him.
Lendo disihlule bonke abantu, let me just leave it as it is.
No one can tame him and nami ngimande ngishiye kanjalo.
But we see the Lord.
Siyayibona kodwa inkosi.
Esondele eduze kwakhe.
Coming near to him.
And he's getting his deliverance.
Uthola nokuphulukiswa kwakhe nokuhlenga
kwakhe. After he has after he had received his deliverance.
Emva kwamukela ukuhlenga nokusindiswa kwakhe.
Sesiyaqala siyambona manje ukuthi hawu kanti umuntu ophilayo.
We can now see that no, he is a man, he's alive.
Ofuna ngisho ukulandela inkosi uJesu.
Also wants to follow after the Lord.
But we do see the Lord know it, no hambe ekhaya.
But we see the Lord saying, go home
and tell what God has done for you.
Ufakaze ngalokhu uNkulunkulu akwenzele khona.
So uyabona ukuthi ke this can be summarized.
Lokhu ke singafinqa sithi
by bringing it closer to us.
Ngokukuletha la kuthina sikusondeza kuthina.
And saying in our midst as the church.
Sithi ke phakathi kwethu njengebandla.
Kunezimo ezibukeka kusengazuthi azisoze zalunga.
There are situations that seem as if they will never be well.
Kunezimo ezibukeka sengazuthi enkonzweni noma endlini kaNkuluNkulu kunje lokho akuseze kulunge.
There are situations in the house of the Lord that seems like they will never change.
But what is the Lord saying?
Kodwa ngithini inkosi?
Uthi approach those situations.
Uthi ke iyani kuzo lezo zimo.
Ngamehlo akhe.
With his eyes.
Approach those situations.
Iyani kuzo lezo zimo.
Unenhliziyo yakhe.
With his heart.
Because with your own heart.
Ngoba ngeyakhe inhliziyo.
And by your own eyes.
Nangamehlo akho.
Kubukeka kunzima.
It seems difficult.
But through his own eyes.
Kodwa ngawakhe amehlo.
It is very easy. We have to understand, bazalwane, that the next person is not your assignment. The next person is not your project. But we are all here and it's a project.
We are all the project that belongs to God.
Someone once said, ukuthi ibandla is the same as the hospital.
Khona wathi the church can be likened to isibhedlela.
Sihlukene ngamawodi.
We are all in different wards.
Khona abanye abagula abane heart failure.
Others have heart failure.
Abanye they are in mental institutions.
Abanye base la kumele belashwe khona ingqondo.
Manje into eyinkinga ke ngalabo abaku mental institution.
Those akumele belashwe ingqondo.
Is that abayiboni bonke bayagula.
They cannot see that there is something wrong with them.
Babona labo abane heart failure ukuthi bayagula.
They can see those abanenkinga yenhliziyo
that there is something wrong with them. But actually ukugula la kuyafana.
But it's the same sickness here.
Ukuthi ugula uyagula.
Yes, you are sick.
Kodwa manje inkinga ukuthi ubambeke endaweni ehlukile kunomunye.
But now it is different from the next person.
So into ebalulekile that you need to do.
What is most important ekumele uyenze
is to allow therapy to come to you.
Ukuthi uvumele usizo lufinyelele kuwena.
Now the therapy in the house of God is not the medication.
Usizo endlini kaNkuluNkulu akulona ikhambi.
But therapy in the house of God is the word.
Kodwa kuyizwi.
Therapy in the house of God
usizo endlini kaNkulunkulu ukululekwa.
Therapy in the house of God
usizo endlini kaNkulunkulu
is allowing the spirit of God to dwell richly in you.
Uvumela uboya kaNkulunkulu ukuthi akhe ngaphakathi
and allow him to influence even the way you do things.
Uvumela ukuthi abe nomthelela nasekwenzeni izinto.
So in the house of God there is no place
endlini kaNkulunkulu ayikho indawo
of serving by emotions
lokuthi ukhonze ngemizwa yakho
of serving by the flesh
ukhonze uholwa inyama
ngoba bazolimala abantu
because people will be hurt.
Amen. Ungahamba ni 100 nithi hayi siyoshumayela mfundisi Mayiwa eDandi.
You may go being 100 people saying you're going to preach at Dandi.
Ufike nje ungasindiswa umuntu.
And nobody will be saved.
Uhambe ni wherever.
Wherever you may go.
Uthi mhlamba ake shintshe eDandi.
And he said okay maybe let us change location.
Mhlamba ke siye enqutu.
Maybe let us go to enqutu.
Ngoba umakhelwane.
Because it is nearer.
Ufike enqutu ungasindiswa umuntu.
And nobody gets saved.
Ufika amakhehla kwaShembe nje eyihambela inyawo.
You find the elderly men of uShembe.
Ufike izangoma zehla zenyuka.
You find izangoma going about.
Ubona iZayoni zehla zenyuka.
You see the Zion is going about.
Uthi uyalishumayela izwi.
As you try and you preach the word.
Kube sengazuthi izwi kaNkulunkulu lishaya idwala.
It's as if it's hitting against a rock.
And
then he said, no, let us move.
I say Port Shepstone.
Let us go to Port Shepstone.
If you,
when you get there,
same old. Why
is it so?
It is because you have taken umsebenzi kaNkulunkulu.
The work of God.
And
it became your own work.
And
it was no longer the work of God.
Amen. That's what you'd be shocked. I was actually thinking about this Apostle BL. When we came to the church,
it was 2014.
At Durban, 2013 in Maritzburg, because we started there. When we came, Bible study would have, we used to use this venue. Bible study will have abantu lapha abahamba lapha emuva kugcwele.
We would be
fully
packed. We'll pack this room.
Now, can you imagine if besenza umsebenzi wenkosi siwenza ngenyama?
If we were being led by the flesh doing the work of
because
the Lord,
because we'll be looking at the numbers.
Ngoba sesibheka ukugcwala kwabantu.
And say ukuthi hayi okusho ukuthi uyenzeka umsebenzi.
Which means that the work of the Lord is carrying on.
Manje, no, the Lord is not concerned about numbers.
Inkosi ayibheki nani labantu.
The Lord is concerned about quality.
Inkosi ibheka uhlobo oluthile.
Ngabe kade sayeka.
We would have quit a long time.
I don't know about the senior apostle. Mhlambe ngabathi that hayi inkosi is coming.
Maybe he would have quit a long time. People are leaving.
I'm just leaving this
things
thing.
Are happening. I'm not going to share parts.
It goes to show ukuthi la emsebenzini wenkosi.
Yeah, saying is that in the work of the Lord, we are not led by the flesh.
But we are led by the Spirit
God.
Of
God. Umoya kaNkulunkulu.
Amen. And the Holy Spirit is not concerned about what we see physically. But he is concerned about our souls making it to the kingdom of God. Are you going to his kingdom? Are you heading towards that direction?
We are praying now.
Are you heading towards that direction?
We are corner here.
Are you keeping his pace when it comes to prayer?
We are clean and it's been this.
Are you serving the Lord faithfully?
We are konza inkosi ngokuthembeka.
Are you serving him faithfully when it comes to prayer?
Umkhonza ngokuthembeka yini uma sikhuluma ngomkhuleko.
Or whenever you are offended,
noma la umkhubeke khona,
you leave everything behind.
Ushiya yonke into.
You forsake the work of the Lord.
Ushiya umsebenzi wenkosi.
That is why izwi likaNkulunkulu cannot be founded upon emotions.
Ingakho the word of God alikwazi ukuthola isekelo salo kwimizwa.
Because emotions are labile.
Ngoba imizwa iyehle iyenyuka.
Amen. We need to have courage.
Kumele sibe nesibindi.
When it comes to serving.
Uma sesikhuluma ngokukhonza.
Because we are going to meet hardships.
Ngoba sizohlangana nobunzima.
We are going to meet difficulties.
Sizohlangana nobunzima nezinkathi ezinzima.
But we need to take heed.
Kodwa kumele silalele.
And press on.
Sicindezele siphokophele.
Because we have heard the voice.
Ngoba silizwile iphimbo.
Of the one who commissioned us.
Salo osithumile.
Amen.
Amen. Have you been commissioned?
Umzwile nokuthumile.
Have you heard the one who has commissioned you?
No mutunyiwe nje.
Or you have just been commissioned.
For the sake of being sent.
Ngenxa nje ukuthi uthunywe.
You must hear.
Kumele uzwe.
And the direction must be clear.
Kube khona nendlela ecacile kumele
ihambe. Because when God gives a commission.
Ngoba uNkulunkulu ekunikeza umsebenzi noma
when God gives mandate.
uNkulunkulu ekunikeza umsebenzi.
It is always clear. Look at the Old Testament.
Big Testament eldala.
Everything was always clear.
Yonke into yayihlezi icacile.
And God gives fine details.
UNkulunkulu uletha nemininingwane ecacile
kakhulu. Of that which he wants.
Kalokhu yena akufunayo.
Amen. Now the question is,
umbuzo uthi,
are you in that path?
Ukuleyo ndlela yini?
Are you amounting to that which God
uhamba kulokhu
desires?
UNkulunkulu akufunayo yini?
Amen.
Amen.
Kalung ipe next slide, then we stop.
Mark chapter 5, from verse 15 to verse 20. And they began to entreat him to depart from their region. And as he was getting into the boat, the man who had been demon-possessed was entreating him that he might accompany him. And he did not let him, but he said to him, go home to your people and report to them what great things the Lord has done for you and how he had mercy on you. And he went away and began to proclaim in Decapolis what great things Jesus had done for him. And everyone marveled.
Do you see the end results?
Yes, bona isiphetho noma impumela
of courageous service.
So ukukhonza ngesibindi.
Courageous service.
Ukukhonza ngesibindi
gives these results.
Uletha lo mphumela.
Now, I'm sure we are seated here, we are wondering how many people this man encountered after this. And this, his deliverance impacted abantu abangakanani.
How many people did it impact?
Izinto zikaNkulunkulu azijahi.
The matters of God are not in a rush.
Izinto zikaNkulunkulu azisumlilo wamaphepha.
It is not fire that easily dies.
Izinto zikaNkulunkulu,
the things of God,
azenzeki nje noma kanjani.
Don't just happen.
But they happen.
Kodwa zenzeka
to ensure that Christ is revealed.
Uqinisekisa ukuthi uKristu uyavezwa.
Can you imagine the Lord Jesus Christ walking with his disciples?
It
is kaNkulunkulu kwakuswelekile ukuthi adlule eSamaria.
The word of God said it was imperative for him to go through Samaria.
Can you imagine if he didn't go there?
Uma ukuthi akadlulanga lapho.
He was not going to meet that woman.
Why ngeke azahlangana nalo wesifazane?
And at the point of him meeting that woman,
that
woman goes
and
is telling people about the Lord.
That I have seen the one who has told me all.
So we are born ukuthi it's not just a matter of ukuthi bahlangana kuphela lapho.
They don't only just meet and then it ends there.
But there must be results.
Kodwa kumele kube khona impumela.
There must be results.
Kumele kube khona impumela.
I'm sure the Lord would have taken another path.
Inkosi mhlawumbe engahamba ngenye indlela.
That would have led him to his destiny.
Lezo misa la kumele aye khona.
But he decides.
Kodwa uyanquma.
Ukudlula nje ukudlula eSamaria.
For him to pass through Samaria.
Because this woman must get the encounter. And after her getting the encounter, then she must go and bring others to the point of knowing.
The question is, as we're closing, you knowing Christ, how many people is it impacting?
How many people
banga kabantu
came to the knowledge of Christ?
Abafike kumazini uJesu.
Because you are in Christ.
Ngoba wena ukuKristu.
How many people
banga kabantu
get to know the Lord through your character?
Abakwazi ukwazana nenkosi ngesimilo sakho.
How many people get to know the Lord through you just living?
Bangake abantu abakwazi ukwazana nenkosi bebuka wena uphila.
Amen.
Amen.
Bangake.
How many?
No, I want you ukuthi uyibuze wena, sibuze impela wena.
Ask yourself this question. Ask yourself.
Ngizokunikeza impela nomi 1 second.
I'll give you a second.
Ufuna wena, ask yourself.
I want you uzibuze wena.
Ukuthi bangaki?
As to how many
abafikile kumazini uKristu?
People who have come to the knowledge of Christ.
Because I was faithful in the mandate that I've been given by the Lord.
Ngithembekile kumsebenzi wokuphila.
To live
ukuphila
a life of faithfulness,
impilo yokuthembeka
to the Lord,
enkosini,
and not to people.
Ngingathembeki kubantu.
Bangaki?
How many?
I'm sure usucabangile.
Ngiyacabanga ukuthi that you have given it some thought.
Uma ngabe kuwukuthi uthuthu uyabala,
if you're counting,
inamba ayihlangani.
The numbers are not coming together.
Hayi, mhlambe ithuba lakho lokuthi uze ngaphambili.
Maybe this is an opportunity to come to the altar.
Uzothi Nkosi,
and say, Lord,
ngiyacela ukuthi impilo yami from this point onwards,
I ask that my life kusukela manje
from this point onwards.
Usukela manje.
Ngiyacela kube impilo that is going to be meaningful.
Let it be a life ezoba nomthelela.
Remember we said kunabantu abangakaphili according to i-calendar kaNkulunkulu.
Bese sishilo ukuthi according to the calendar of God there are people that have not started living
because they have not tapped
ngoba abakafiki
to that which is written
kulokhu okulotshiwe
by God himself
ngalokho okulotshwe uNkulunkulu
about them
ngabo.
Currently impilo iphilayo.
The life that you are living.
Do you think yiloko kubhaliwe kwi divine diary kaNkulunkulu?
Umucabanga kuyahambisana nalokho kulotshiwe kuhlelo lukaNkulunkulu.
Noma usayiphilela nje.
Or you just still living.
Okushuthi ngokaNkulunkulu akwaqaqala ukuphila
akwaqa exist. According to God you have not started living yet.
Mawuyibona ukuthi ayi Nkosi lempilo engiyiphilayo.
If you can see that the life that you are living
akusiyona le ngicabanga ukuthi iyona loyifunayo.
Is not the life that was destined by the Lord for you to live.
Remember awuzokusizwa ukuze esontweni.
Khumbula coming to church will not help you.
Do not play church.
Ungadlali ukuze enkonzweni.
Mawusindiswa sindiswa ngempela.
If you get saved get truly saved.
Ngoba njengamanje asekho isikhathi.
Because right now there is no time.
Cela size ngaphambili.
Let us come to the altar.
Sizokhuleka.
And we will pray.